few minutes and we will start the session today. Okay, so we will start the session. Today is the last session for the live classes also, and we will discuss the last class, whatever last week, whatever sir taught. Okay, week 4. Now, last week we discussed about the conventional superconductors. So today we are going to discuss about the unconventional superconductor. So so what is unconventional superconductor? The base material which shows the unconventional superconductor is Li2CuO4. Okay, so it is an antiferromagnetic insulator. if we reduce the temperature below the certain values, if you can see the page diagram here, below the certain value, it shows the superconductivity. So above, it has a, it become a normal metal. Here in the case La to CuO4, it is a insulator. Okay. Now, if there will be normal dopings are used to happen in the place of doping with. SR and bismuth also. If so, lithium lanthanum is replacing with bismuth, similarly doping with zirconium. So this doping also, what will happen when we are doping with zirconium or bismuth, it will show the superconductivity. Okay. When we add Ba, like there are other doping also, La(2−X), BaX and CuO4. So when we are doping with barium in the site of length La, it will show the superconductivity. When we add the barium, it will create a hole in the system, and with this hole is the making the superconductive nature to the system. And other things we are learned is electron hole doped superconductor. So electron hole doped superconductor examples are given here. These are the this Nd(2−X), CeX, copper oxide. Similarly, Pr(2−X), CeX, CuO4, samarium Sm(2−X), CeX, CuO4, and lanthanum and Pr(1−X), CeX, CuO4. CuO4. These all are electron doped superconductors, and all doped superconductors are yttrium compounds and bismuth and lanthanum compounds, which are doped with the zirconium. So these are the hole doped superconductors, which more application is coming from the hole doped superconductors. After that, we learned about the features of unconventional superconductors. So first feature is D-wave pairing symmetry that we discussed in the last class also. Normally in the conventional superconductors, if you plot Kx Ky diagram, so if we are plotting Kx here and Ky diagram, what will happen, we'll get like this. It will be like an isotropic figure, and we are only interested in the band gap, superconductivity gap. So that value is delta. So which will be uniform throughout the system and isotropic in only all the direction. But in case of unconventional superconductor, what will happen, that we discussed in the last class, it will be like four nodes will form. Okay, so nodes means that crossing points. So there will be gap is zero. Normally there are will be four nodes in that case. Then after that, pairing being formed at the normal state and domed shaped superconductivity. That is what I explained here in this figure. If you see this figure, at this point the maximum spin density wave you will get, it's a pseudo gap. At this point it will be superconducting. So below this point and after this point, the superconducting nature is reducing. So this domed shape superconductivity is getting after doping the system. And undoped state is antiferromagnetic insulator. So normal case, so that's what here I said, if you take the base example La2CuO4, it is antiferromagnetic, and the antiferromagnetic insulator is a antiferromagnetic insulator with the undoped state. When we are doping with some other zirconium and all, it is getting the superconducting state, and the shape will be the domed shaped superconductivity. And if you say the strong electron-electron correlation, what will happen if the we have to add the interactive term, we have to add to it, like if the example for epsilon is equal to epsilon r plus I epsilon I, Okay, so the real time and imaginary time. So these are the extra time we have to add for the electron-electron correlation. And if the temperature increases, what will happen? In unconventional superconductor, electrons will showing the pairing. Okay, so like the Cooper pair, you will get it in the case if the temperature increases. At certain temperature, it will be. So these are the things in first class for the first lectures are taught. So this is a brief idea. Here you have to remember about the unconventional superconductivity material.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Can I ask you a question about the submissions of our assignments?
Yeah.
Tell. Actually, ma'am, I have submitted the assignment, but still in the course, it is showing that my course progress, there is no any marking that how much marks I have obtained in that assignment or something like that.
What about other RU people are getting? Like
no.
Only you are getting like that or others also?
I have no idea about others. So if
sometimes, like, they will assess the last, they will keep the progress last, like marks, but I don't know if others also similar, then they are will analyze it last. But if others are getting, then you are not getting, you have to write a query in that NPTEL. So did you do that?
No, nothing now.
Oh, you please make it, okay? Please raise that question in that platform. There will be like, you can raise questions and all, right? Chat part is there.
Okay, I will send it. It is showing I have submitted
because
the file.
Your exam in the next week or something, or when it will be? March?
Sorry, ma'am?
No. When you have exam for superconductivity? They already told the date, right?
Yeah.
When it will
I have submitted before the date.
Okay. Before that, they will give the assessment mark, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you raise the question. If possible, now itself you made it, okay?
Okay, I will try.
Now we will go to the next part, the second video summary. So here like sir explained the phase diagram of unconventional superconductor. For example, if we draw okay, first it will show the antiferromagnetic state. Okay, then after that there will be superconductivity state, and in middle one pseudo state also there. Okay, now next it will be the drawbacks of classical theory of electron or free electron theory. So there will be a two anomaly there, that is specific heat CV and the susceptibility value. So specific heat, normally what we learn, what it is, CV is equal to 3/2 kb. So here CV is directly proportional to the temperature, okay? And susceptibility of free moments, what it will be, chi is proportional to 1/2, see, inversely proportional. And here we will get the chi value is constant. So these two things we cannot explain by the classical theory. Then it came to the Landau's Fermi liquid theory, which allows the small interaction. So what we are doing here, it is like here we introduce, like included the free electron term, and like epsilon is equal to epsilon real part minus I epsilon imaginary part, and the wave function psi of t will be e to the power minus I epsilon r t divided by h cross e to the power minus I epsilon I t divided by h cross. So this will be the wave function value. This it is a like exponential decay term, which signify the decay of the particle here. Okay. So that is the first thing which is happening, like renormalize the energy value. So how we are renormalizing it, we have to add the external imaginary part, and we are making the renormalizing the wave function with the extra term. So with that extra term, it will come a decaying term. In the decaying term, which actually represent the decaying of the particle. After what we learn is particle hole excitations and Landau quasi particle renormalization of mass. So what we are doing is like here also there will be additional interactive term, that free electron theory like what it will so square well we are learning. For example, if it is like this, 0 to from 0 to a, the waveform, if we say the levels, the wave function will be first one like this, and this is the second one, third ones are like this. Okay, so in Fermilab theory we are adding more terms and it become a harmonic oscillator potential. So how it look like then? It will be like a harmonic oscillator potential, then it will be E is equal to n plus half h cross. So we can see the one-to-one correspondence here, like this n is equal to 1 here. We have to renormalize masses here, that we will write n 10 raised to m star, then all the remaining part the n will be in terms of m star. We have to do the solve the wave equation and etc. and to find the values, even values and etc. So these derivations and all you can get from this last lecture. So this is the brief of the second lecture. What happened? Door is open, no? Door is open, right? Oh, that's all you got. Now we will go to the third lecture. So last lecture there were actually six. Last week there were actually six lectures are there, but last week lecture are half an hour remaining for our 1 hour lecture. So in lecture 3 we were discussing about the breakdown of Fermi liquid theory. So earlier what we did, breakdown of drawbacks of classical theory and this Fermi liquid theory came, but after that there are some limitations for the Fermi liquid theory also. First one is it's unable to explain quasi particle lifetime, it is small. So for example, this lifetime tau e is proportional to e square, and that is proportional to the temperature square also. Okay, so along with the time the quasi particle is decaying. So before turning on the harmonic oscillator potential, the quasi particle starts to decay. So the whole the theory become the breakdown in that case. So that is what happening in the quasi particle lifetime part. Then energy level crossing. So for example, when the n is increasing, the gap also increasing in the square wave potential. So what will happen in the first level here, second the n is equal to 1, n equal to 2, and 3 will be n is equal to 3. So this gap, which is increasing as the value of n is increases. Okay, and for example, if it is here, okay, and the harmonic oscillator potential will be equal gap. So this will interact with here, it will interact with here. So that's why the energy level crossing we are saying. So here at the high energy values the energy bands will cross each other. And the next one is temperature dependent of hole current and usual current. So hole current, it will be proportional to the T square, and the usual current, which is proportional to the temperature T. Okay, then next was topic point is vicinity of the quantum critical points, and the few characteristics of high TC superconductors were discussed in that class. the fourth lecture. Discussed about the Josephson effect, AC Josephson and DC Josephson effect, and so how it is happening, like this is like a interfacing of two superconducting materials. For example, if it is S1 and this is S2, and they were interface, normally it will be alumina like Al2O3. Okay. Interfacing is nothing but two superconducting conductors are connected together and the properties of it. Okay. So there are four kind of junctions are there. First one, tunnel junction, then proximity junction, microbead junction, and point contact junction. So in case of tunnel junction, this is the same, like two superconductor is like in here tunneling effect will be happen. And proximity functions is like in junction how it will be, two superconductors are separated like S1 and S2, and in middle it will be normal matter. Okay, so in microbead junction, how it will be like, there will be S1, two superconductors, both will be same superconductor, so it's also S, we can call this also S, and this will be like paper kind of, this junction is called the microjunction. And point contact junction is like one superconductor to other superconductor, it's like a point contact between the those two superconductors. Okay, so the main application of it is like oscillators, amplifiers, and SQID devices, SQID devices, that we will discuss later. Okay, these are the main applications of this, and after that we discuss about the critical current. So critical current, like this, that current value the superconductor will destroy. So if you start to apply current from 0 ampere to the system at a particular current value, the superconductivity will become zero. The current is known as the critical current. Okay, then he discussed about the application of Josephson junctions, and Josephson equations are there. So there are two Josephson equations. First one, it's explaining the current. So I is equal to IC sine delta phi value, where phi is the phase. So we can delta phi, we can have phi 1 minus phi 2. Okay, and second one is, it's related to the voltage. So for example, if we explain earlier this tunneling part, so there if we connect it with a voltage V, okay, plus or minus, plus here minus will come, then this Josephson delta, second one is the d by dt of delta phi, that will be equal to 2V divided by H plus. So this is the second Josephson equation. And for AC Josephson effect, DC voltage is applying and the current is fluctuating. Okay, so for the AC Josephson effect, what will happen? DC voltage we are giving the as input while applying, and the current will be fluctuating one. And in the case of DC Josephson effect, what will happen? The current is constant here and the voltage is fluctuating. So I will be IC sine 2EVT divided by H cross. Okay. Now next one is IV characteristics and its work done. So IV characteristic plot will be okay. So this is potential. This value will be IC, the critical current. Then we talk about the vector in this case. So these are the fourth lecture. please go to it once.
Excuse me, ma'am, how thick is the Josephson junction?
What, what?
How much thick is the Josephson junction?
How much?
Thickness of the junction.
Oh, your voice is not clear. Can you put it in the chat box? I'll check it.
How much is the thickness of the junction, I'm saying?
Like normally. Okay, so normal the experimental order, for example, if the lead is the superconducting material we are applying, okay, and the barrier will be lead oxide, okay, in such cases it will be 2000 angstrom thickness and 0.3 millimeter width. Okay, then junction area normally it will be 0.1 millimeter square, that will be the tunneling area of it.
Okay,
it should be very small to cross the barrier to the electron.
Did it vary for all the junctions, like for
yes.
Tunnel?
Yes, yes. The, but if the tunneling junction, then it will vary.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
lecture, he taught about the AC Josephson effect. So here he explained the Josephson frequency, that is FV is equal to times 10 to the power 12 visual cell, depends on visual values. Okay, and there will be induced current, which means a circuit, and it will be inductive circuit and inductive current. So it will like which you have in the inductance. So the L value will be there, and the symbol for Josephson effect will be like this. Is the Josephson junction symbol, and we are connecting with the voltage values, so AC or DC according to that. Okay. There is an important part is superconducting quantum interface device, that is SQUID. Okay. So how it will be the interface device? So there will be like two junctions will be there. This first superconducting one and another superconductor. Okay, and this is the junction, and here we are applying the resistance across it. So these two resistance, like which is avoid the hysteresis losses. Okay, and we are applying the two coils here. Here the input one, and here the output inductive coil. And this device, which is used to measure the magnetic flux. Okay, so the least value, it is till minus 10 to the power minus 15 tesla. We can measure it. For example, the magnetic products by Hertz and these all things can measure using these devices. It will detect the very small range of the magnetic field. Okay, now the flux, if we draw the relation between voltage and flux, it will come like this. Okay, and that's this difference. We can call it as phi zero value. Okay, so the external flux values changes with the with respect to the voltage, which whatever we are applying. So this is the last video of this course. So here which explain the RF skewed and DC skewed. Okay, RF skewed which is depends on the quantum interface, two phases are interfere each other. Okay, so like here we are using as a radio frequency as the input wave, and like it will be one, and the DC it will come to two crossings or two superconductors will be there, and DC current only will supply to the system, and this is the one which is using for the practical uses. And so DC is going to be total current circulating to the loop and phase difference around the loop and total flux and squid with self inductance and maximum current versus external flux plot. So how it look like this, like for example these are the to superconducting material. So here I current is passing and it will be I1 and this will be I2, and it passes through here and it will reach as a I to the outside. Okay, so total I, the current you can represent as I1 plus I2 here. So I1 will be IC sin phi and the this I2 value will be IC here sin phi 1 here sin phi 2. So there is the radiations which is available in the class. Now we will solve the problems related to the Josephson method with IC values and HC and skin depth also. So these are like those are the main problems which are asked in the exam also. Now before going to them we will discuss some problems like which came in the assignment. So the first one is what are the main assumptions of Fermi liquid theory and describe the conjecture of the adiabatic continuity and what are the signature of breakdown of FLT in cuprate superconductors. Okay, so here what you have to do is you have to explain like what we discussed in the second slide here. So these all NPTEL, quasi-particle lifetimes and energy level crossing, temperature dependence of hall current and usual current, and vicinity of quantum particle critical point. These all things you have to explain in this part. And this interactive part, like epsilon changes to epsilon r minus I epsilon I, this one, and the mass changing part m changes to m psi. This all are you have to explain here. Please go to the next question. So here you have to write the Josephson's equation. First we discussed the two equations in last slides, and it's for current and voltage across the trial junction between the two superconductors. Okay. Now after that, AC and Josephson effect, you have to explain like and compute the wave functions, and hence current inside the tunnel barrier of width minus A by KT plus A by KT. So what you have to do is like the barrier will be minus A by T2 plus A by 2 x axis. The barrier width is here, it will be 0. Okay, now you have to write the wave functions like psi of x, it will be sin C1 sin x over theta plus C2 cos h x over theta. Okay, then normalization part, c1 square plus c2 square, it will be 1, and the psi of minus a by 2, it will be root n1 into the power I 511, psi of minus plus a by 2, it will be root I 582. Okay, then I can do the density Js value, it will be Jc sin pi 1 minus pi 2. So these all things are already derived in the class. You have to explain these things to compare it. Let us go to the third problem. Describe the working principle of SQID and what are the its applications. So the VI characteristic of speed and how does they determine the critical current. So here you have two. That's one question we already discussed, and we have to tell the how the Joseph junction is used and what are the application and IV characteristics like. This you have to explain. And see the fourth problem here. For DC circuit as shown in the figure, figure is given below. We obtain the an expression for the total current circulating in the loop. Express your result in terms of sum and difference of the phases and the wave function phi 1 and phi 2. Find an expression for phi 1 minus phi 2 from the phase difference around the loop. Now compute the total flux phi, assuming L to be the self-inductance of the circuit and phi external is the flux due to the applied magnetic field B, and express in terms of any one of the phase phi 1 and phi 2. What is the maximum current Imax for L is equal to 0? Present a schematic plot of Imax as a function of external flux phi external. Okay. Establish the connection with Young's double slit experiment in optics. What are the sources of phase difference in this case? So these things it's already explained in the class here. This will be similar. You have to explain this kind of, you have to second question. You have to explain the wave functions values and flux values also here. And Young's double slit experiment, like its interference will happen if the two slits are there. Okay, then it will interfere. If the one junction and one slit case, there won't be any interference. If the two slits come, then only the interfaces will happen. So those I have to compare it is a connection with the Young's experiment, and all other things are already the same kind of problem, which same kind which is derived in the class. You have to cross check it and find the answer for this section. Please go through it, and if you have any doubts, let me know. let us go to the next one. Draw the screen. Screen current IS as the function of the operate magnetic field. Magnetic flux by image script setup. Explain the variation. In the second question, present the schematic plot of output voltage as the function of the applied magnetic flux phi. Last problem, describe the different junction write on the expression for current and voltage in terms of phase phi and condensate wave functions. Okay, and I describe AC and DC Josephson effect. Consider a Josephson junction extending from minus A to plus A and is modeled by a barrier height V0, the greater than the biasing energy is zero. Both sides of which are superconducting described by a condensate wave function psi is equal to, which is given here, psi 1 is equal to root n1 into the power I phi 1 and psi 2 is equal to root of n to the power e I phi 2, and n1 and n2 are the superfluid densities. Assume no external magnet flux being present. So here the B value will be 0. Write down the Schrodinger equation and apply appropriate boundary conditions and obtain the expression for current through the junction in terms of n1, n2 and phi 1 and phi 2. So this you can explain whatever I derived like this. Okay, so you have to change the boundary from minus A to A and make the sides, find the wave function and apply the, do the normalization part and get the values of it. This is the way you have to solve this problem. And the BI question is very easy. You have to describe ACD and DC Josephson effect, that I already discussed in the second slide. So that will be the answer for this. And describe the Josephson junction and write down the expression for current and voltage. Those two are the two Josephson equation. That's also we already discussed in the class. So please go through it and get back to me if you have any doubt on this part. these are the six theory questions which we discussed. Now we will go to the fundamental problems. The first problem is superconducting. Tin has a critical temperature of 3.7 Kelvin at 0-90 field and a critical field of 0.0306 Tesla at 0 Kelvin. Find the critical field of at 2 Kelvin. So here the values which are given is TC value, which is given the 3.7 Kelvin, and H0 value that also given 0.036 Tesla at T is equal to 0 Kelvin. Okay, now I have to find HC of T where T is equal to 2 Kelvin. So HC of T, you can write it as a formula, HC times 1 over T divided by TC whole power 2. We have to just substitute the values which are given in the question, we will get the value for the critical field at 2 Kelvin. Substitute all the values. There will be 0.36 times 1 minus 2 divided by 3.7 whole square. So you will get the answer 0.0216 Tesla. So now let us go to the next problem. The transition temperature for PB is 7.2 Kelvin. However, at 5 Kelvin it loses the superconductive property. It is subjected to a magnetic field of 3.3 times 10 to the power 4 ampere per meter. Find the maximum value of H which will allow metal to retain its superconductivity at 0 Kelvin. So here, let us solve a little bit carefully. So that the values, first of whatever the given values, which will be C, TC is equal to 7.2 Kelvin, HC of T you have, that is given 3.3 times 10 to the power 4 ampere per meter, and the temperature is given 5 Kelvin. Okay, now here you have to find HCO value for it at T is equal to 0 Kelvin. So from using the same equation, HCO of T is equal to HCO times 1 over T divided by TC whole square. So from there you have to find the value of HCO, it will be HC divided by whole square. So substitute the given value here, then you will get the answer for this. It will have to, you can substitute it 3.2 times 10 to the power 4 divided by 1 minus 5 divided by 7.2 whole square. So please do this and find the answer for the H0. What is the answer you got for this? How much is the x0 value here? Yeah, it will be 6.37 times 10 to the power
ampere per meter.
Yeah. Now let us move to the next problem. Superconducting transition temperature of lead is 7.26 Kelvin and the initial field at 0 Kelvin is 64 times 10 to the power 3 ampere per meter. Calculate the critical field at 5 Kelvin. So here also you have to calculate the critical field. So the AC value which is given 7.26 Kelvin and H0 value will be 64 times 10 to the power 3 ampere per meter at 0 Kelvin. Okay. Now use the same formula. 0 times 1 minus T divided by TC whole square. Substitute the value, so it will be 64 times 10 to the power 3 times 1 minus 5 over 7.26 whole square. And find the answer for this critical field. How much you got the answer? Yeah, it will be 23.64 times 10 to the power 3 ampere per meter. Yeah, now let us go to the next problem. Calculate the critical current density for 1 millimeter. Diameter lead wire at 4.2 Kelvin and 7 Kelvin. A parabolic dependence of magnetic field strength which is AC and may be assumed for the calculation. For lead TV is equal to 7.2 Kelvin and HC is equal to 6.5 times 10 to the power 4 ampere per meter. So here we have to be very careful. You have to calculate the IC value the formula, it will be HC 2 pi R, and similarly JC values also, that will be IC divided by pi R square. Okay. So first you have to do HC of T, that is equal to so first one HC of 4.2 you have to do and find the answer for it. Similarly its IC value and corresponding JC values also. Is for 4.2 Kelvin, similarly you have to do the same for CT is equal to 7 Kelvin. So here also HC of 7 Kelvin and IC value and corresponding JC value of it. After solving, substituting the value, we have to get its C value is 4.2 times 10 to the power ampere per meter. Similarly, IC value should be 1349 angstrom, and AC value will be 1.71 times 10 to the power 8 ampere per meter square. This is for case of T is equal to 4.2, and in the case of T is equal to 7 Kelvin, the HC value will be 0.356 times 10 to the power 4 ampere per meter, and IC value will be 11.17 amperes, and JC value will be JC, you have to calculate IC by pi r square, then it will be 1.42 times 10 to the power 7 ampere per meter square. These are the some kind of problem which is mainly asked in the exams also. If you see the assignment problems only, you can get similar kind of problems. So try to solve this and study the derivation part for your exam and solve the all the assignment problem, and just go through the earlier live sessions videos, which will be helpful for to solve the problems in the exams. Okay, then we will wind up the classes here. All the best for your exam for this course. So please go through all the four lectures and find the solution. If you have any doubt, please put it in the NPTEL platform. We will try to answer for that. Okay.